So we have the PDF. Uh-huh. It's linked in the Slack. I'd love it if we could, everybody could take one step.
Mm.
And we'll just pass along until we get like all the way for anybody who wants to do it. I don't know if Fuji wants to be involved with this or not because he's very busy with Minesweeper.
Wait, that's what that who that Chris is?
Yeah.
Minesweeper.
Yeah.
Chris yeah. I would like Minesweeper to
Chris,
stay on
doing?
The screen during the Lego.
Yeah.
This was as far as we got in our
oh,
Lego.
So I'd love to just do like another like 9 steps since we have 9 squares up. I don't
sure.
know if we can actually get an overhead though. Can we actually get the overhead?
I mean,
I kind of want to take like.
I mean, I can change our camera to overhead if they can't. That's fine. Yeah. Here, I'll give you those.
What? Where is the instructions?
They were linked inside.
They should be.
They are
on
DB
Peach
stage.
Yeah,
they should be.
Thank you, Peach.
As well.
While they're setting that up, does anybody want to hit that orange button?
Is that the one that makes me leave and go to bed?
No, I almost
that?
Made it.
No.
It has been my goal to stick my face down there in time, and I'm
Beach, did you write down what last step we were on last night?
Thought I did.
God, okay.
Peach says that they did not.
They did not?
Well, I mean, it was the last Zeta shift.
I'll have a look in the book and see if see where we left off, because I'm pretty sure we're into the 80s.
Take a look. It's in the book.
Is it
the book of instructions?
Reading Lego.
It's a reading Lego.
That was really good. Oh my god.
It looks like you have up to 86 written down as done, so you're on 87.
All right.
Real quick, hey Molly, I was excited to be on a shift with you. I'm on a shift with you now.
I already did it.
Pages.
Hey neighbor.
Hey.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
How do you?
And again, a heads up, nobody can actually guess what this is. It's been it's made completely impossible.
You can't tell until the final piece is in place what this mystical thing is.
What page of 80 should I be looking at?
I mean,
at?
No, you
it's
step
a vehicle,
87.
Right?
I,
it'll be like page 25 in the PDF, thereabouts.
Page 26.
Step 87 is only on page 25 of an 80 page PDF?
There's like
PDF?
500 steps.
Yeah.
We're going to still be
like
solving this.
Pieces.
Yep. Yeah, by next year's Desert Bus, we're still going to be solving
it. It is the mystery of the ages.
I picked a big one so we could actually keep doing it this year and then do it next year.
Also, did we point out that the person reading the instructions generally does not watch the preview to see what is actually happening?
Correct.
Yeah, you can't watch the preview.
I'm watching the bus.
If you're familiar with the game Stop Talking and Nobody Explodes, that's kind of the idea.
Keep talking and nobody explodes,
right.
But I like how you came up with your own version.
Stop talking
stop
and everybody
talking.
It's like labor under a threat.
Like, I'm sorry.
Just shut up. Everyone shut up.
I have some bus brain and sometimes I have some desires late at night.
All right.
Max, the sort of Zeta tradition this year was somebody with strings would sort of noodle while Lego was happening, so you're cordially invited
do
to do so. Yeah.
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 We will probably have
probably,
to duck,
I'll probably
your
do
audio
that.
A bit, but yeah.
Yeah, I think a little pits would be nice, a little pizzicato.
Yeah, yeah. I'll do some of that. I'll probably do that instead of reading.
That's awesome.
And I do want to stress that if you don't want to read this, you don't have to.
Absolutely, you can just pass.
Zeta is a very consensual shift.
Yes, we are. Can't spell consensual without sensual.
Yeah, I was just going to say that, yeah.
Cut!
No. You need to get closer into the mic. You need to be like, sensual.
Yeah, there we go.
Say it is about consent.
Beej, when this is all over, do you want to come over and watch Con Air with me?
I really do, actually.
Yeah. Throw it in Discord.
Joe.
Hey, Joe.
So I'm just previewing this here, and you said something about reading. But I don't see any words.
That's correct.
Yeah.
You're going to have to describe to me. I hope we can see it on the overhead, or some of, at least the chat can. But your job is to describe to me where what pieces I'm to grab and where I'm to put them.
Without looking at what he's doing.
You cannot look at what I'm doing. You'll pick up on the terminology, I'm sure, as we go along, but I believe Heather gets to go first.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Right, so, I mean, I do know what step you're on. So we're on step 87.
I believe so.
You need 2 1-by-1
dark chocolate?
Dark chocolate blocks.
Yes, I have 2 1-by-1 dark chocolate blocks, I do.
Oh, wow, this is the first time I'm seeing these instructions, actually. I can understand why people couldn't tell the browns apart very well.
Yep.
2 1-by-4 milk chocolate blocks.
I figured that would be next, yes. I've grabbed those as well.
And 1 2-by-4 milk chocolate block.
1 2-by-4?
Mm-hmm.
Milk chocolate block, I have found it.
Okay. You're going to take those 2 1-by-4 pieces.
Yes.
And butt them up against, on the very top layer, where the 2x4 pieces are.
Yes.
They're going to cover all of the pips in front in one line.
How do I open the door? Okay.
Okay. Well, keep rolling. Keep on rolling.
I don't believe I can.
You're good.
You just have to scooch.
You're good. You're good.
Into the range.
Never give up.
Yeah, right.
You just have to be in range.
I mean, I'm trying to accelerate, and it's not. Did the preview pause? What happened?
It is. You're good. You're good. On the left-hand side of the road.
Yep.
Oh.
You're driving.
Thank goodness.
Oh, that was okay. Amazing. If you can't bus stop, don't crash. Those
My
are two
preview's
important.
Frozen. Okay, there we go.
Okay.
Did it.
Okay.
All right, so Heather, let's try that again. Okay. I have the 2 1-by-4 bricks. Yeah.
They're gonna make one very long line together.
Oh, I see.
And they're gonna cover from. They're gonna butt up against on the top layer of your big chunky thing.
Yes.
The 2 2x4s. All the way from the red hollow pip down to the blue hollow pip.
So they go on top of the. They go on top of the red hollow pip and the blue hollow pip?
Yeah.
Okay. So they're next to, they're not on top of. All right.
Well, I said kissed, but yes. I guess that's more me and Molly's terminology. Yeah.
Okay. So I've covered a red hollow pip and then 6 brown pips and then a blue hollow pip.
Yeah. So you should have 1 red hollow pip and 1 blue hollow pip still visible.
I have that.
Visible? Okay,
yes.
Good. You're going to... take the 2x4.
I have it.
And you're going to put that also to the left of the ones you just put down, directly in the middle.
How do I orient it?
Lengthwise, north-south.
North-south. I'm covering nothing but solid pips?
You're covering nothing but solid pips. It should be right in the middle so that... if it was right next to the big long line that you made,
I've done this.
You would still have 2 kind of over each side. Yep. I'm sure you have this down.
Okay.
You're going to take the 1x1.
Yes.
And put it. You're going to put 1 directly north and 1 directly south, touching the 2x4, but also touching the 1x4s.
And I'm covering brown pips, I'm guessing?
You should be covering brown pips,
I'm covering
based on
brown
what I'm
pips.
Seeing.
Okay, I have done this.
All right, that's step 87.
All right, who's reading 88?
Who would like to read step 88?
Well, the next one in the rotation, I think.
Julie?
This would be Julie.
Oh, God, okay.
You don't have to.
Yeah, you can skip.
You can call pass.
I mean, it all depends on how invested you are in having this work.
Oh,
we're not.
Not.
No.
It's better if it doesn't.
Okay.
Beej, do you know what this is, or have any idea what it is?
No one has any clue what
no,
it is.
Oh, no, we have no idea.
No.
So
yeah, it's impossible to know.
Yeah.
Yeah. We burnt the cover of the book.
Oh!
Yeah.
And the box.
Okay, but it did, okay.
And we didn't even open all the bags.
The edges of this PDF file are slightly singed and crumbling to pieces under the touch of my mouse cursor.
Yeah.
If this helps anyone who has not done this before, your basic Lego brick we often refer to as bricks, but the thinner pieces we typically refer to as tiles.
I was gonna call them flat boys.
Yep.
That works too.
I like this. I'm gonna hear your take on this.
Okay, so we got a total of 4 flat boys here. There are 2, I guess 1x2 light brown flat boys?
Probably mid-brown flat boys. We're going to call that mid-brown.
Okay, it looks kind of like
caramel.
How my mom has her coffee, which is too milky.
Yeah, that's me. So 2 1x2 flat boys, yeah.
Yep, and then a single 1x4 red flat boy.
I found that.
And then one. Okay, so I guess this is like a really light colored. It also doesn't help that my my monitors have gone into night mode, so they've switched to that warmer light tone. So everything looks kind of sepia.
Mm-hmm.
So that's gonna spice things up. But it looks kind of like a creamy flat boy, 2x4.
I do have that.
Perfect, just one of those.
I have one of those.
Okay, so do you have the main structure that you're working on? Is it like a car battery if it had a little bit of a, I don't know, like a booty?
Yeah.
Okay, so.
How would you like me to orient it?
I would have the booty point, like the booty point north.
Okay, I'm doing that.
Okay. So it looks like, and so when the booty's pointing north, there's like a, like kind of a rectangular crevice. South of the booty.
Yes, there is.
Adjacent to the booty. Okay.
How big is that crevice? If you were to describe it with a number of pips, how many pips would fit in that crevice?
I would say like 2x3.
Yep, you're correct.
Okay, perfect. Okay. So, red flap. Okay, I gotta have a look here now.
Yep.
Booty proximal.
So I'm trying to tell.
I love this booty. These...
Sometimes it's easier if you skip to the next step because the line drawings. But
our numbers are very nice right now.
9, 6, 6, 6, 9.
Yeah.
Six,
bye. The lines... Okay, I see. So this is gonna go.
Bye.
Okay, so this whole mass is going to be centered, and it's going to actually, we're going to cover that rectangular crevice.
Okay.
So that's good. That'll be our little secret once this is done.
Mm-hmm.
So why don't we start with the red flat boy?
Okay.
And that is going to go over the, oh gosh.
Tell me how to orient it.
Orient it longwise against the cross-section face of the booty.
So do you want me to turn it north-south or east-west?
East-west.
East-west, okay. It is a horizontal piece now.
Yes. And then, so red longboy is going to go down. It's going to center and span that crevice.
Yes.
So it's like in the northmost pips.
Right next to where the booty is, yeah?
Yeah, hugging the booty.
I have done this.
Hug that booty.
Embrace the booty.
And then the two small flat boys
mm-hmm.
are gonna kind of, they're gonna go north-south and then frame the red flat boy.
So you want me to go just a pip next to the red on either?
Yeah, top pip next to the red.
Okay, but they're oriented north-south, you're saying?
Yes, so it forms kind of like a bracket.
Yeah, I think I know what you're saying. I believe I am doing this right now. I have done this.
Okay, great. And then like the biggest flat boy is also going to go east-west, and it's going to be tucked right into that bracket that you've just created, and it's going to fully seal that crevice.
All right, I have done this.
Excellent. That is step 88.
Good job.
All right. Matthews, you want to take step 89?
Sure.
Yes. All right.
So I have a question though. Are there YouTube videos of people doing just this?
This.
Where other people are reading out the directions to them?
Yeah.
I doubt it.
Only by us.
Yeah.
Desert Bus YouTube.
Technically, it does exist. I just know that like kids love those videos of watching people unbox things or unwrap mm-hmm. toys. I yep. feel like.
This feels like the exact opposite of that.
I discovered in London Drugs one day there was a whole toy line of toys who they're dolls that unbox things.
Really?
So oh you can play with these dolls and make them unbox. They come with tiny boxes, and you can purchase little goodie bags with more boxes for them to open.
No.
I like a little GoPro for them to make a little channel and like their doll tube.
Yeah, it's pretty horrible.
Liz, I challenge you to ask chat exactly how calming they find this.
But I mean, kids today, my 6-year-old nephew is obsessed with Legos. I think yesterday he was telling me how he was going to make a video for the desert bus entry and how, and at the end of the video it said like and subscribe. And he,
that's awesome.
I don't even know if he knows what that means. He doesn't, but he did say that he was going to make it so that if you go to his webpage, it would automatically subscribe you to his YouTube channel.
Oh.
Okay. Wow. So well,
smart.
When he figures out how to do that, let us know too.
Yeah.
That'd be really great.
He said, like and subscribe. Haha, you don't have to because you're already subscribed.
Oh, wow. Man. Can we get Twitch integration too? That would be stellar. Yeah.
Okay. All right, Matthews, are you ready to go?
Yep.
All right.
All right, so this step is pretty quick.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to need two pieces. First is a flat 2x6 that is black.
I found it.
Excellent. And then you will need a flat 1x4 that is red.
I have that as well.
Awesome. So you know the assembly that you just made with Julie?
Correct.
So you're going to put that... the black 2x6 right over top of the 2x6 portion of that assembly.
I am doing that right now.
Awesome.
I have done this.
And then you're going to put that 1x4 right on top of the exposed 4 bricks that are left from that assembly that you just made.
I have done this as well.
And that's step 89.
Lovely. Thank you.
Swag.
Rock and roll.
Molly, are you driving?
Yes, I am.
Do you want someone to take over?
I would just prefer that somebody read.
All right. So, step 90. We need another 1x4 flat red.
I found it.
A very creamy flat boy of a 2x4.
I have that as well.
And then we need two mid-brown chocolate milk. Ball joints.
Chocolate milk.
Oh, that's
they are knobby. They're like an axle.
Yeah. Thing.
Okay. They hang off the back of your truck like a ball hitch, and some people dingle dangle things underneath them.
Some people dingle dangle dingle dangles.
They have hollow pips on top.
They have hollow pips on top. Okay. Please describe the piece in more detail.
It looks like it's wearing a clown nose.
How many pips does it have?
Two.
And what are there? What is its configuration? A 1x2?
Yeah, it's a 1x2.
Okay.
There's two of them.
And then does it? Are they? Is the ball hang off the end, or does the ball hang off the side?
Oh, we sideballing.
Sideballing. How many of these do I need?
Two.
Yeah.
I found two of these.
Yeah,
want
to take that one again?
No. You don't have to take anything again at Omega Shift. That's the whole point.
That's okay. I was just checking. You know, sometimes people want to take things again.
It's good to check.
I feel like this has been a great dress rehearsal. Should we start Desert Buzz? What do you think?
I can't. It's
just take it from the top.
So you have four pieces, Beej.
I have four pieces, yes.
All right. Atop the black platform.
Yes.
You've got it oriented so that's north?
The black platform is more north, yes.
Okay, so... top row, red, in the middle.
Top row, red. Okay.
Top row, so red. You're going to have some black pips on either side of that.
I see. Okay. So
east-west.
So if the black piece itself is east-west, the red piece is also east-west.
Yes, it covers in the middle.
It covers the northernmost black ones?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep.
So I believe I've done this properly, yes.
Okay, below that is our creamy lad.
Ah, I see. So, sandwiching these together. I've done this.
Yeah. And then on the black pips that are exposed, you've got your knobby boys facing outward.
Oh, what an interesting idea. All right, I have put the knobby boys on this. Two knobs are now, one is facing west, one is facing east.
All right, you have completed step 90.
Cool.
That's the knob.
The pressure. Okay, 91. Okay. Are you ready, Beej?
I am ready, yes.
Okay. Oh, man. So we have five pieces. Okay, I guess the best thing to do is collect the pieces first.
Yes, please.
Yes.
It's a light chocolate.
Yeah, like caramel color.
Well, yes, there's a scale here. It's not quite a creamy chocolate.
All right.
But it's not quite dark chocolate. So I'm looking for, or no, you now are looking for two 1x1s.
So single pip, bricks or tiles?
Yeah. Bricks.
Two 1x1s in kind of a nice milk chocolate color as opposed to a caramel color. All right.
Yeah.
So darker than caramel, but lighter than like dark chocolate. I see.
Right.
I have two 1x1 pips, bricks.
Okay, and as far as my eyes can tell me, we also need two black bricks that are 1x2.
I have both of those.
Okay. And then one for our final piece. It is a caramel color. Mm-hmm. Or lighter brown color. Mm-hmm. It is a, what is that? That's 2x4 brick.
A 2x4 brick, you say?
Mm-hmm.
1 second.
Canvas.
2x4 brick.
I'm worried my step's the one that's gonna make it messed up and summon some sort of demon.
Now you're getting
Liz,
it.
At the beginning of one of our shifts, I kept looking for pieces that didn't exist because I miscounted them no matter what I did. So it's okay. I spent 5 minutes trying to figure out why a piece that didn't exist wasn't there, and it was, and Beej had to come over and point it out to me that I was counting wrong. It was okay. You were doing great.
Yay!
So you said 2x4.
Uh-huh.
It's in caramel color.
Yep.
And it's a brick, not a tile?
Correct.
2x4.
Okay, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, numbers are correct. Okay. Perhaps it's a color. It's not the lightest. No.
Right.
But it's the it's. Why did you get all brown?
I know, right?
That was kind of part of the, right? This was kind of the reason.
Oh, right. You're like, I want to make poo. Okay.
He's doing a bit.
There's a bit?
See. I mean, it's a brick, really.
Yeah.
I will give you some additional help, Liz, and say that on the previous step, the red brick he placed, the way he's got the model oriented, that's horizontal east-west.
Right. Okay. So the butt's facing north.
That's correct.
Yes.
All butts to the north. Got it.
Yeah.
Stick all butts in the air.
That's how sailors find their way home.
I'm having a hard time finding this brick, though, and I'm
You're worried that we missed a piece?
I'm worried that it might have just fallen on the floor, but I'm just having a look at it.
I'll take a look on the floor.
Just grope around with your toes.
Yeah.
Get up and go to the bathroom. You'll find it.
Put some ham on those feet and then walk around and it'll stick to the ham.
It's a brick.
Perfect. Put some jelly on that.
That's also a good trick for picking up bits of broken glass.
I'm grabbing
just walk around with ham wrapped around your feet.
Yep.
Getting rid of anything that's 2x4 just out of my vision so I don't have to see it anymore. And if I pick up a brick
dish, the little shards you can't see. Nope.
Would you put socks on over the ham?
If
you're feeling a little cold.
Little hawk
only
socks.
If they're wool.
Yeah, you need something that you want something that'll retain the moisture.
Yeah.
Socks for your hawks.
Hawk socks.
Hawk socks. Hawk socks. Woo!
Love that show.
Ham is like a hurricane.
Like a hurricane here in Beej's feet.
It used to be like Hamburg, but now.
Oh, Can't Wear Hats just showed me up with pigs in a blanket.
The only brick I actually have been able to find so far is a 1x4.
I have a solution for you if you can't find that brick.
What's that?
Look in the other bags. And
have
fish
you not
one
checked
out.
The other bags?
Well, we should have opened all the bags that we need to actually have opened.
I know,
point.
Know, but if you just kind of look for it, if you can find another one, open it, fish it out. Don't throw all the pieces down.
No. Are you worried about 6 hours from now when we do the next bag?
Yeah, potentially.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're you know.
You know, Heather telling me I should go looking for the next piece. I have looked through 4 bags, and I have not been able to find.
Yeah. I bet I could find it.
I found one now in bag 11.
Perfect. Just have that
many
one.
How many bags are there?
11.
Yep.
Don't worry. This will only affect the last step then.
Yeah.
Have you been able to find any 2x4 bricks?
I mean, I have some 2x4 bricks on the build. but I haven't found any 2x4 bricks in my open bags so far. I have a bunch of 2x4 tiles, but I have no bricks.
Okay, so it's not like it's a color.
No, I kind of took a look at his spread, and I couldn't see a brick in there. I think we may just be missing a piece.
That's frustrating.
You could probably whittle it out of ham, but...
All right.
Just saw a piece in half.
All right, so I've located a 2x4 brick.
Awesome.
In mid-brown.
Okay.
That's the right one.
See if I can do this. Now, if I can figure this out, it appears that you recently have placed some sideballs.
Yes.
Would you like some sideballs?
Sideballs.
Some tasteful sideball. And, okay, so the 2x4 brick that you have just should be south of that sort of stack of, let's see, the red and the cream-colored flat boys.
So when you say south, you want it to kind of butt up against the edge of it.
Yeah, yeah, and there should be one row, a gap, at the edge of the square in the south.
He said
yeah,
that
makes perfect sense.
Okay, good.
And I have done this.
Yay! Okay, now now we're going to give it little dog ears to that piece.
Cool.
Like it's trying to do caramel dancing or something.
Boop, all boop. Right.
So then you'll have, it's going to mirror each side. So let's start with the east side.
Okay.
What up? You'll take the black 2x1 and that will be right up against, so it'll be north, south.
Great.
And one of its little pips is going to butt up against the sideball and the other one is going to butt up against the new piece you just placed. So it's kind of like extend. That.
It leaves that brown pip uncovered. The one just below, one just south of it.
Right, of the 2x4.
Thank you, I've done this.
Okay, then you are going to put, so the black part is like the top of the ear and then it's got a little flappy ear. So the 1x1 is gonna go at the, right next to the east of the north side of the black piece.
The east of the north side of the black piece. So
it'll be like right, it'll be like looking at that sideball, like, hey, what up?
Oh, so it's right, it's nearer to the sideball, but it's right next to the black piece.
Correct.
I've done this.
Okay. Now, I want to turn the picture around, but I can't because it's a photo.
Am I mirroring this on the other side?
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
Can you move your pieces up, Beej?
Yes, I can. I can do that.
Thank you.
Is this also a good position for the build?
I would also move more to the right.
Build here?
Yes.
I will build there.
This is the most inspiring Lego music I have ever had.
Nice,
thank
right?
you, Max.
The sound of pips like Max, being snapped together.
I feel like Max believes in us.
I do. But is there angry, judgmental fiddle music? Does that exist?
what's almost the fiddle sound for you goofed up your build?
I mean, I've been playing all sort of major jigs here.
Who is remaining?
Let's see. I think I'm up next. Sweeper or there's James?
I think James is up next.
All right,
sounds
James.
Good.
All right, Beej.
Yep.
You remember way back on step 90 there with the sideballs?
Yep.
You grabbed a 4x1 flat red boy and a 2x4 light brown flat boy as well.
Yes.
You can see. Yeah.
Yep.
So what you're going to want to do is place these two pieces directly on top of where they were placed in 90, but you want to swap them around.
Okay, so I'm taking another 1x4 red and another 2x4 creamy nice white boy.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And I want to cover the red and part of the white with the white boy.
That is correct.
And I want to cover the remaining white with the red boy.
That is correct.
I have done this.
We only had to do two pieces. I just want to say.
Yeah.
Do you want him to do another step?
I'll do another step. Yeah. Beej, 93, let's go.
Yep.
We need a 1x1 flat boy, another nice creamy 2x1 or 2x4 flat boy.
You need a 1x1 flat boy?
Two 1x1 yellow flat boys.
Oh, two bone. Okay. Do they have pips on top?
Yes, sir, they do.
I have 2 1x1 flat boys.
And you're going to want that 2x4?
I have a 2x4 in white, yes.
All right, you're going to put that 2x4 in the white right in front of the red 2 1x4 that you just placed.
East, west, or north, south?
You can go east, west.
Yep.
South of that red.
Yep. I'm covering up those brown bits. I believe the brown bits.
I trust you. All right. Now you're going to want to take those 2 1x1 yellow flat boys,
mm-hmm.
and on the north side of that 2x4 that you just placed, on the left and right, you're going to want to place those 1x1 yellow flat boys.
What color am I covering?
You're covering, I believe, the north half of the black from back in 91.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So the north part of that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can do that. And
cool beans.
I have done that.
Great.
Show off.
I can keep going all day long.
That was good, James.
Does somebody does James want to keep going? Does somebody else want to sub in for James?
No, I want to see where James takes us.
All right.
All right.
Let's go. 94, Beej. I need you to grab a 2x1. We're going to call it, I guess, medium brown.
Yeah,
I think that's what we've been calling them.
Caramel color. You want a 2x1 tile?
Yeah, two by one tile or flat boy. I don't know.
Yeah,
the terminology is just flipping back and forth.
I know.
And I need a 1x4, or I need 2 1x4 flat boys.
Yeah, in the same color.
Yes, sir.
I have found them.
And then, wait, what? Oh, yeah. Okay. Oh God. Okay.
Yeah, James, come on.
The first 1x4 flat boy is going to nestle right up on the north side of that little butt area you got going on.
So I have 4 uncovered brown pips at the top. You want me to cover those with this brown thing?
Yes, please.
I'm doing that now. It is done.
Okay, then you're going to take the 2x1 and the 4x1 and basically create a 6x1.
Uh-huh.
And place that directly south of what you just did, splitting the difference. So one pip on either side of the should over, like, go over the 4x1 that you just placed.
Are you sure?
That's interesting.
It should go over it, James? Are you sure?
I mean, yes.
It are is, you sure?
So I can only place... I can't put a 1x6 on top of those 4 pips.
Going in for a closer inspection. One moment.
Sure.
You sure? You just didn't try hard enough, Beej?
If he wants it oriented east-west, there's no way I'm going to be able to do it.
So it looks like it should overlap the 2x1 brick aspect of those sideball boys that we placed a few blocks back.
Okay.
So it should go along east to west.
Yep.
Overlapping those two ball boys.
I can do that. Now, which do you want, the 1x2 on the west side or the east side?
I want the 1x2 on the west side.
Okay, I will do this. I am covering 3 white pips and a hollow brown pip with the 1x4, and I'm covering a hollow brown pip and a solid white pip with the 1x2.
I believe that sounds good.
Chris, okay. Fugi, did you lose?
No.
Oh.
I had 3 50-50 squares on this map.
Oh,
I got the first one. I lost the second.
That's heartbreaking.
Yeah, it should be illegal.
Fun fact, I haven't heard your voice for like 9 days and it's freaking me out.
Love you, James.
I love you too, buddy. Am I still going here?
Yeah, unless somebody else wants to jump in.
Only if you want to.
Yeah.
I mean, I'll keep going, but sure. I don't want to hog it from other people.
Jason, did you want a Lego?
No, I just want James to keep going.
Thank you, Jigsaw.
All right, Beej.
Yep.
I need a medium brown 1x4, 2x2, and 2x4 flat boy.
1x4, 2x2, and a 2x4. All three of them flat boys.
Yes, sir.
1x4, 2x2, 2x4. I have all three of these flat boys.
Okay. Take that 2x2.
Yep.
And place the 2x4 next to it, so it is a east by west long piece.
Oh, I see. Yes.
And then you're going to put the 1x4, you're going to take those and place them right in front of what we just placed.
Okay. Where would you like the 2x2 to be, on the west or the east?
On the west.
Okay. Interesting idea. But yeah, I've done that. It is fitting, it fits perfectly.
Perfect. Now you're going to take that 1x4 and place it directly south. I believe you're going to be covering a very creamy white.
I am covering those. Perfect. And at least four other white ones directly south of that uncovered.
I believe... Oh, yeah.
It doesn't leave a gap, so if it's sistered right up against it, it's got to fit right there. So, okay.
Well, yeah, let's say we're looking good.
I'm confident.
Oh, bus. Yo, 96 has got some whack pieces, yo.
I can't wait. I was waiting for this moment.
Yo, these are some, like, 2x1 curvy boys.
Yeah, okay, good.
I'd love to take a stab at describing 97.
Oh, please.
Oh.
But they're on 96 for right now.
Yeah, I'll guide through Beej. I'll guide Beej through 96 and then pass Julie over 97.
No, I don't really trust anyone else from here on.
All right.
You got those curvy boys?
No, because I need a better explanation as to what they are.
Okay.
Are they quarter circle curves, or are they just a single?
They are quarter circle 2x1 curves.
Okay.
Quarter circle.
How many of them do I need?
Two.
I only need two. Okay. So if I put them side by side, they would make a half circle, correct?
Correct.
Quarter circle 2x1.
And they're very flat. They're not a high arch. They're very flat.
Sure.
Okay. Are they if I stood them up, are they brick height or taller?
Yeah, they're taller. Okay. Like they should be equivalent of a, like, a 1x2 high brick.
Yeah, I think I know what you're talking about now. Okay. I think I have the right things.
Okay. So you're going to want to take those, and they're going to go on the east and west side. There should be a little bit of a step down just in front of the ball, the exposed ball on either side.
That's correct, yes.
So I need you to place...
It works when it's exposed. Yeah. Now that's what gets me.
So you're going to want to place those on those two, that step down.
And do these intersect... Like, does the top piece intersect with the brown, or does the bottom piece intersect with the dark chocolate brown, is what I'm asking? Or are they plugging into the black ones?
It doesn't look like... No, they are plugging into... So it looks like there should be a two-step down, like a one-step down between the ball and the black one, the exposed black. We're looking for one pip... north of the black.
Yes.
There should be basically a two-step down that this should fit quite nicely in.
But it doesn't cover the black. It's not coming down towards me. It's coming down towards the ball, the way the ball is pointing.
Yes, correct. It's facing east to west.
Okay. But the top piece of this little staircase circle is actually plugging into the top brown pieces, correct? The top medium brown pieces?
It appears like it should be... No.
No, it plugs into the... So the top piece plugs into the 1x1 brown piece that's there.
Yes.
It comes off that down next to it. This finishes flush to the edge of the entire piece.
That is how I believe it should look. Okay. Yes.
and is finishing in the same direction as that. And I believe, oh yeah, that's so, sister's up so nice. James, I think we got the right thing here.
Perfect.
So we've kind of enclosed those balls a little bit.
Correct. You have provided them a safe space to nourish.
Great.
Whatever the word is. I'm very tired.
Do. Yeah, dangle. Anyway.
Dangly balls.
What's next?
I mean, Julie seemed very excited to do 97.
I want
to
hear Julie describe 97.
All right.
So we got two curvy boys, but they're wider.
Okay.
They're a little wider. They look about twice as wide as the ones that James had you pull out.
I see.
Why did Lego get so sexy?
It's a very erotic exercise, really.
So you wanted... Then,
established it was sensual.
How many of these do you need, Julie?
There are two.
And they're 2x2. If you were to orient them with pips underneath, they'd be like a 2x2?
I think so, yeah.
And they have a deep drop?
Yeah.
Oh. Okay, I'm fine.
Yeah, we've been doing this every night. It's so difficult.
And found one.
So much tension.
I found two.
Okay, this is good. And then there's two pieces that look like, on the diagram, a quarter titty.
Okay, I'm just doing the math in my head of what that would look like. So, like, kind of a...
like a butt?
Are they very flat?
They have a curve to them.
Sure, but I mean, they're like, if you took a quarter circle, right, like a dome. I guess I'm asking about a dome. Are these like...
Yeah, but like a dome, but the shape is more like, it's not a spherical dome. It's like, if you imagine kind of like the 80s cone bra kind of titty.
Oh, I sure can.
Yeah, they've got that kind of a shape to them. You're basically, I think we're building a second booty on this,
Oh, this are structure. We? Do they have little markings on them?
Yeah, that's the nipple.
Yeah, they have little tiny black markings on them?
Yes.
I have found them, building? Two little tiny black markings on them.
Are they thick? Are they thick with two C's?
And they have kind of, if I was to look underneath them, it kind of looks like a Q-bert level. They're very, very tall. Yeah.
Yes.
All right, I feel you.
All right, so you're gonna keep those titties apart, though. And it looks like, actually, there's kind of...
separate.
Yeah, they have indentations on the bottom, which is, I guess, where stuff goes.
Yep.
And there's markings on them that, I guess, kind of look like little eyebrows, maybe, like they're happy.
Yeah, I think I got your eyebrow thing, yeah.
Yeah, so, like, you want to orient them so they're, like, you want to space them so that, oh boy, okay.
The eyebrows are if the booty is facing away from me, the eyebrows are facing towards me.
Yes. Okay. And the eyebrows are making a happy, kind of a happy, like...
That's the best lyric I ever...
like a happy, kamoji kind of... expression.
I believe I can do this, yeah. There's only really one way they can fit is for them to face me, so, okay.
Yeah, and then between them are the two curvy boys.
Yep.
Following their curvature, and you're basically going to mirror the back booty, and we're going to give it a front booty.
All right.
On those two front tiers, facing you on the south end.
So I'm covering the white and I'm covering that white bit right now. The white tile.
Looks like it.
We are about to have a real problem.
Well, it looks like it should exactly mirror what's going on with the rear booty.
Sure.
The north-facing booty.
I'm just here to tell you that I'm pretty sure that we have created something a little too tall.
Oh, no.
What have you created?
Is there
it's probably okay if there's a gap in the back booty or the front booty, whichever one this is.
You gotta exhaust that booty.
You said there was... These were going on a white piece?
Yeah, I don't see a white piece.
You shouldn't have any white exposed.
There should be no white exposed?
Yeah. Only the light brown and the black. The two black.
You should have completely covered all of your white areas in step 95 with James.
Yeah.
Interesting. All right. Do we want to take a step back?
Hashtag blame James.
Can I propose some terminology?
Yeah.
The sort of nipple pieces on top, we call those pips.
Yes.
Right? The sort of negative thing that chunks onto the pip, I propose we call those pops.
That sounds awesome.
Okay.
So I'm showing four white pips still uncovered, but those were supposed to have been covered.
Yeah.
So was I supposed to cover that with a 2x4 or with a or is a supposed to cover that front one with a 1x4?
1x4 it looks like.
I see.
Yeah.
So am I missing a piece there, or should I actually have moved everything forward somewhat?
Because I've been following along with what people have been saying, and so you should have grabbed all the right pieces.
Yeah.
So there was that part where next to the back booty, mm-hmm. you had that like 1x4 indentation, and you covered that with a 1x4 piece.
I did, yes.
And then south of that, you would have covered it with a 1x2 and a 1x4 that are making a 1x6.
Correct.
And then south of that, you should have covered, there should be a 2x4, no, sorry, a 2x2 and a 2x4 making a 2x6.
Correct.
And then south of that, there should be a 1x4.
Yes.
And that should that 1x4 should actually be covering the second white area.
So is there, oh, neat. So maybe I'm not supposed to have a, how do you get this off when this happens? Oh, like that.
Class one levers, how?
Yeah, instructions for how to use the tool are on the first page.
Yeah, I think. I figured it out.
Never got that far.
Okay, so I have a 2x4 white here.
Yeah, so you should have had half of that covered by the 2x2 and the 2x4 makes the 2x6.
This is the brick explosion we were trying to avoid.
Yeah, that's okay. So I have a red line in the middle here. Should I not have had that red line between the two yellows?
No, the red line is right.
The red line should not be between the two yellows. The 2x4 white one should have two yellows between it. But you do need to have a 1x4 red.
The 1x4 red should be in line with the southernmost pops on the sideball pieces.
Yeah.
Okay, so if I walk back just a little bit more. So you're saying that the red line is supposed to be in line with the southern pops on those balls, right?
Yeah, the two hollow pips.
So if I do that, is there supposed to be a white piece that goes just directly north of that?
Yes.
Yeah, it's a 2x4 white piece.
And it slides in between the booty, does it?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Interesting. That's really cool. I've done that thing. So then south of that red piece
is a 2x4.
Is a 2x4 white piece, right?
Ah, yeah. Okay.
Yes.
With the yellows on the side of...
Yeah. Okay. That looks right. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So if I do that, then we put a 1x4 medium brown between the booty.
Yep.
Directly south of that, we put a 1x2 and a 1x4.
Yep.
And then as a 1x6.
And then directly south of that, I put a 2x2 and a 2x4, which makes a 2x6, and I cover that, and I'm now covering that yellow bit, and I leave one line of white uncovered, and I cover that white with a 1x4.
Yes.
Yes.
I have done this.
And then the step pieces you guys did for, like, the weird curve steps for 96 should still be in the right place.
Yep. They just go right here.
Okay.
And like magic, we have created a completely smooth curve.
Yeah, there you go.
Yay!
Fix your booties.
Good job, everybody. We got there.
Woo!
All right.
So have you gotten back to the titty point?
The quarter titties are on.
Great.
And I put the nice smooth front on this, the forehead on this thing. It looks like a forehead.
Perfect.
Oh, ooh, titty. Awesome.
Bread. You made bread.
Get that forehead between the two titties. Anyway, so what's the... do we keep going? Do we? Because we can. I don't mind. I know we're trying to eat hours here, and I certainly, you know.
All right, here. Let me redeem myself.
All right.
All right. Mm-hmm. You need 2 1x2 slanty boys.
Are they hard slants?
Yes, they are hard slants.
They're not a curved slant, they're a hard slant.
No, they are. They look to be about a 45, well, probably not that harsh, but...
Like a 30.
Yeah, probably about a 30 degree, light brown, medium brown slant. And then we also need a 2x4 of the same color.
A 2x4 of the same color, yes. I have those over here. So I need 2 1x2 with a hard slant?
Yeah.
I have that.
Okay. So on the very top,
yep.
You have a, it looks like a 4x5 area of pips.
Yes.
At the very top. Is that correct? And then you have two 1x3s on the side.
Correct. Yes.
Okay. You're going to take that 2x4
mm-hmm.
and place it, on the third and fourth row from south to north, facing east to west. So there's going to be a row of 1x4 above it to the north.
Yes, I'm doing this now.
Okay.
Okay, so it's kind of in line with the balls.
Yes, it is.
Great, I have done this.
Okay. Now you're going to take the two slanty boys.
Yep.
The slants are going to peak on the west and slope to the east. Okay. One is going to go butt up against the west side of the 2x4 that you just placed on the outside by the ball.
Okay, I'm just gonna have a look here. So does it overhang the ball at all?
No. Okay. It should be 2x1 north to south.
2x1 north to south. 2x1 north to south. It butts up against
the 2x4 that you just placed.
Yep.
And the slant should peak at the west and slant down towards the bricks that you just placed.
Oh. I think I have it incorrect. I'm sorry, I'm just gonna pull that 2x4 off that you've told me to place. So the 2x4, it oriented east-west.
Yes.
It sits on top of the at the north side. There's a line of 1x4s. I leave that uncovered.
Yes.
But I come down and I cover the next 2x4. The next 2x4 dead center, which leaves on my left hand side and my right hand side, or my west and my east side. There's 2 pips uncovered to the west and 2 pips uncovered to the east.
Yes. Well, there should be 3 uncovered to the west.
Technically,
and east.
Yes. Yeah.
Yes. Okay, so you're going to want, again, so you take that 2x1 slanty boy.
Yep.
It's
like a wedge, right?
It's not. It's a 2x1 where it's too long. Like the slant is. God, how do I describe this?
Is it a smooth curve? Like is it just a is it like a if it's not a wedge?
It's not a wedge.
It's not a scalene triangle. Okay, I understand. I had the wrong pieces. That's why.
Okay.
So let me just look for another 2x1 that has a curve on it. Aha. Okay. So is the curve isn't. If I hold the 1x2, this is the only other way this can be, but I think I just want to be sure about this. If I was to hold the 1x2 north south, it curves it peaks on the east and troughs on the west, right? I have to hold it north south in order for that to happen.
It should peak on the west.
Okay, I just have to turn around in my hand. If I hold it north south and it peaks on the west. And it troughs on the east.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. But I'm still holding it north south. So it's yeah. I'm holding it north south.
Yeah.
Okay.
And that's correct because what you want to do is place it north south, butted up against the 2x4 that you just placed.
Yep. So the high side is near that ball.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. And now what you're going to want to do is orientation wise, the next piece is the exact same. You place it on the east side, but south one pip. So that 1x3, you're actually covering the bottom 2, not okay. The top 2.
And is it? It's oriented the same way, so it's high on the
On the west, sloping to the east.
Okay, I have done that. Interesting, but yeah, I have done that.
Okay.
Okay.
Now what you want is three of those wedge pieces that you had previously.
I have three of those wedge pieces. And they're 1x2s?
Yes, they are 1x2s.
Okay.
Okay, these are all going to be going on the 2x4 that you placed in that last step.
Righto.
They are all going to be peaking at the west and sloping to the east.
Okay.
And two are going to go on the top of the 2x4.
No overhangs?
No overhangs.
Done it.
And the other one is going to split the difference on the south of the...
I have done this.
Okay.
Yeah, with a pip on either side of it. I have done this.
Okay.
Okay.
Wow. Now you're going to want three more wedges, but they're 1x1s.
Okay. I did find some 1x1 wedges, so just let me find all the three of them again. I found two. I found three. Let's go.
Okay. Those are going to go in the same orientation, and they are going to go in the... Where are they going to go?
Just so you're aware, we're going to make you complete up to step 103, and that's where we're going to stop.
Okay, that sounds
okay.
Great.
They're going to go on the 2x4 on either side of the wedge that you just placed.
Right, okay. Same
angle, same orientation, yep.
Okay, gotcha.
And then the other... little wedge is going to go on the available pip on the east side.
Just above the ball.
Yeah.
Okay. I have done this.
Okay. Oh my God.
You've only been up for how many hours?
Okay.
What am I looking for?
You're going to need... Okay. You're going to need total... three more of the 1x1 wedges, uh-huh, and three more of the 2x1 wedges.
Okay, give me 1 second. Three more of the 1x1, three more of the 1x2. I'm missing one of the 1x2s, so I just gotta keep looking here. I didn't null all this earlier, so. I found, okay, I have three 1x1 wedges, and I have three 1x2 wedges.
Okay.
Okay.
So we're on step 101 here, right? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay. Step 101 requires two of the 2x1s and one of the 1x1s.
Okay.
Okay. On the south side, you should still have eight available pips.
I have nine available pips, actually, but...
Nine available pips. Why? Oh, yeah. That's right. Yeah, I can see this now.
A row of five and a row of four.
Okay, so we want to focus on the row of five.
Okay.
All of these are going to continue to be facing the same way as the other ones.
I feel you.
And you're going to go 2-1-2.
Okay, that's so simple. That's so simple. I'm so excited that I'm just putting things down incredibly fast. 2-1-2.
And
got
then
the one in the middle. Yeah, okay, yep. Good.
And then you're going to move down to that 1x4 on the very south.
Yep.
And you're going to go 1-2-1.
Okay. I'm not holding it right. There we go. We're so close here. 1-2-1. I have done this.
Cool. Last step.
What in the hell are these?
That's what? Why this is the last step.
Yes. Fulfill the prophecy, James.
These aren't Lego pieces.
Yeah.
What do you think? These are mega constructs, James.
Yes. Technically mega blocks.
This has never been Lego, James.
Okay.
Lego died 25 years ago on this very night.
What's Lego?
Okay. What we are looking for,
mm-hmm,
are oval flat boys with black oval flat boys with white ovals inside of them.
I mean, I'll look for those. I think I found them.
I would assume they are pretty obvious.
Uh-huh.
You gotta move your hands up higher.
You look like goth Among Us boys.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's definitely what those are.
So you have them?
I do have them in my hands, yes.
Okay, so one side of whatever the hell this thing is has it. Okay, so it looks like it's the...
The nipple side.
Okay, yeah. If you were working on the south side, I think it's the south. It's the south facing side.
Oh, okay. Yeah,
that you were working on. It looks like it has a pretty big wiggly line at the bottom.
Yes.
And a black spot.
Yep.
Okay. There should be four sets of 2x2 exposed, whatever those things are called.
The pips.
Yeah.
The pops.
You're gonna want to put the two pieces that you found on the upper, the two upper ones, with the white oval facing up.
The white oval facing up.
Yeah.
So probably like this. How's that gonna fit?
Ow.
Come on. The white oval facing up. Come on, get in there.
Come on.
It's covering a set of hollow and a set of solid. Does it look like?
Yeah, I think so.
Should be. It's hard to tell from this picture, actually.
Kind of looks like they're all pops to me.
Yeah, it does. Yeah, like the four exposed 2x2s all look like pops. And you're wanting to go on the upper ones. It doesn't show the backside of these black and white ovals, but I assume it should just have the connecting 2x2 on the back of them.
Yeah, technically, yeah.
If not, if you go into the gear room, there's some super glue that you could probably find.
Yeah, I'm kind of tempted. Hang on a second. Let me see here. Do they go like this instead? No, not like that. So they're arranged vertically. The white orb in the middle, like the white little circle oval thing in the middle, is supposed to be
facing up.
Facing up, and on the inside or on the outside?
Inside.
On the inside.
Oh, I remember these pieces. These were the googly glass things.
They literally are too big. Hang on. They won't even go there. They won't go there. They won't go there. They won't go there.
So, maybe each, just to verify here.
Uh-huh.
Your side pips, you should have what looks like a 1x2 square with two hollow pips on the side. Above the squig, like where you're trying to place these eyeballs.
Do they go here?
Yeah.
They don't go there. Don't go there.
I'm concerned because I've seen when I had to build, I've seen these pieces, and I'm concerned that maybe the wrong pieces got slotted in.
Yeah.
Real far back.
well.
Like when you say real far back, do you mean like before I showed up?
Way
because...
before you.
Oh yeah.
Oh. Yeah. You inherited this mess.
Like a few days
but
ago.
We can't really absolve you. Like that doesn't like causation.
Okay.
Yeah.
Like, no, that's fair.
Are you kidding me?
From the looks of the side, it would have been one of Beej's builds.
Can I look at the stream again?
Yeah. No. Yeah. Those are all supposed to be the same.
Yeah, are they all pops, or is it a mix of pops and pips on that side with the squiggly line?
Could it be?
Oh, I just opened it up. Yeah, that's not right.
That's anyway, I'm driving. What's not? Because there's a like tiles that have side pips, and we were talking about there's sometimes side pips that are like up
down,
or downwards.
Yeah.
Maybe we put the wrong side pips
in. Yeah, I think the wrong side pips may have gone in on that side piece, and that would have been like a couple of nights ago.
Like, that would have been like in the 60s.
Yeah.
Somewhere.
Yeah. Like, Beej, you can see those two, I can see the two, the 1x2s at the very top.
These ones here?
Yeah, those should be there should be four sets of 2x2s on all the way down.
Yeah. Really?
Wow. Yeah. Yeah. And I'm seeing pips where I should see pops.
I am
hey, Chris.
This. So we just glue it and then success.
Since this is where we would stop, can I just show you what this is supposed to look like?
Yeah, just hand it over to me so I can have a look at the thing.
Because I think you'll understand if you see it exactly how that's not quite right. Like there's like these two little things that are further down than they should be. They should be up higher.
Yep.
And I think because there's these weird pieces that are exactly the same.
Yep.
But on the side they hang down or they go up, and I think the wrong ones got placed in there.
That is exactly what's happened. The wrong ones got placed in there. Okay.
So those eyeballs are not physically able to go on.
They cannot attach because they will not fit.
But in brighter news, Fugi swept all the mines.
Yay!
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to remove the entire tiny little assembly and just fix that immediately. Because I don't need the ones that hang down. I need the ones that come up.
Yeah, I think it's just a very quick piece replacement.
Yep.
But I can completely see how this got... Because Molly and I discovered these pieces first when we were building. And she described it, and I was like, oh, cool. And I grabbed a couple of them and noticed they were different.
We might not have noticed that there were different kinds of tile with side pip.
I mean, our place of our reading would have been the bottom four section of this, which looks correct. I think the side piece that got mixed up might have been from Beej and Cam.
Because
I remember them pulling up those pieces, and I was like, oh, no, they don't know.
No, we haven't.
They don't know.
Didn't see that they were different.
It's probably fine, though.
It is fine because I've actually just fixed them. It took me that much time to fix them. And I have properly affixed
there.
What looks to be a pair of eyes.
Yeah!
That's
where we're going to stop.
You don't want to...
Do you recognize those eyes?
Do you have any idea how many steps we have to get to those pieces?
No, that's fine.
That's why you're stopping here.
Great, we'll stop here.
I'm stopping here so I could hear James go, what are those and why do I have to describe them?
I cannot wait until we get... Oh, God. Yeah, go ahead.
What?
So just glancing, because of course, again, my monitors have gone into night mode because I should be asleep right now.
Mm-hmm.
Just looking between the manual PDF and the Lego or the not Legos on screen now, and noticing the color difference.
Yes.
In the studio, is the main body of this thing hot dog colored?
sort of cooked hot dog.
Yeah, like caramel brown.
I was afraid of that.
Yeah, we've been using chocolate metaphors.
Yeah,
I don't like that.
The problem, which I'm noticing in the instructions especially, is the dark, what they show as a dark brown, looks very similar to the light brown. Whereas if you can see the dark brown on what Beej is moving around on the sides, it's much more different than what they're showing in the instructions.
Yeah,
that's the insides of the hot dog and ham.
Yeah.
You can also see the beige or cream colored is different than some of these white bricks that we found in mixing the thing as well.
Because when
James was describing where to put the steps for you, and you were asking if it should be on the dark brown because it's a one by one.
Yeah.
In the instructions, it looks exactly the same as the caramel milk colored.
Beautiful.
Which lovely.
Is why that was being a problem.
Ah,
well played.
Y'all did very well, though.
Yeah, I looked at that thing. My heart sank when I realized that we had the wrong direction of external the hanging off pips, and I was just like, "Oh my god!" And I was like, "There's no way we're gonna be able to fix this without taking the whole thing apart." And then I realized, I'm like, "Wait," and the things just come right off, and you can just pull them. And I'm like, "That was on purpose. They did that on purpose because they're like, people are gonna screw this up. We have to be able to fix it. All right."
All right, that's... So
that's Lego, and that takes us up to 4 a.m. It's 2 hours left before we are done with Desert Bus for the year.
Yeah. I'm pushing
that
this orange
button.
That
segment was an hour long.
Yes.
Please.
Prepare for this button.
I'm preparing.